fine concert. And what makes me so glad and joyful is the fact that we are all together to experience the hard work that our students have been accomplishing for months, years for some of us. For many of our students, it's their last concert as an elementary school student. For some, it could be their first concert as an elementary school student. And it's exciting to know that we're all here together to honor the hard work that they've accomplished. We are thankful for your presence here today. We're thankful for the hard work of Mrs. Lisa Gribben, who will conduct both the orchestra as well as the band. Mrs. Allie Williams, who will conduct the hand chimes of Southford Hills First, as well as our chorus. We're very appreciative of the artistry of Mrs. Michelle Marichello, who will be our pianist today. So, without any further ado, would you please give a huge Southford Hills welcome to our Southford Hills band.
His goal was to go all the way around the world for the first time. first time going around all the continents. And I just think it's really fitting to do a song named after our explorer, because what we're doing together is exploring playing instruments for the first time, which is a really exciting adventure, and it takes the same kind of perseverance to build on your skill a little bit at a time until you reach your goal, and here we are. So we're really excited about that. So before we go on to our next song, I want to introduce the band to you a little bit so that you can just see exactly what the makeup is. We have about 70 students on stage, made up of fourth and fifth graders. So fourth graders, raise your hand. Those are all our fourth graders. And fifth graders? So it's about half and half. Back in third grade and choosing their instruments, and we had to give a first, second, and third choice instrument. We were trying to create a really nice balanced instrumentation that has a good representation of all the instruments. So I just want to introduce that to you so you can see what we worked towards when we were making all those little choices and compromises. So I have flutes up here. We had a huge increase to our clarinet section due to a bunch of fifth grade ladies who decided to play clarinet as their beginner instrument in fifth grade, which is super brave. And so now we have a nice full clarinet section. Clarinets, raise them up. And they should be the meat and potatoes of a wind ensemble, and now they are. So it's really nice that we got that instrumentation. We have trumpets in the back row over here. Saxophones in the center field. Two amazing French horn players. Tenor sax. And these three horns over here are actually not tubas. They're called baritone horns. They're like a smaller version of a tuba, but they are low brass baritones. And over there we have a fantastic trombone section. Lift them up, trombone. And I'm not going to forget my amazing bangs, platters, and shaking going on in the back of the session. Percussion can be a really challenging thing to do because you're not just playing one instrument, you're playing several different instruments, and each of them has their own style and technique, so they really take on a big challenge when they're doing that. So, our next song you may have heard in the movies before. Here's Raiders March. Now we're going to play Shepherd's Hay. This one's a challenging song because it has tied rhythms and because it has more sharps and flats than other songs that we've done. So we just kind of try to choose music to have different styles and be challenging in different ways. Here's Shepherd's Hay.
Thank you.
Okay. So I'm going to introduce this group to you as well. So we have about 40 musicians on stage with our orchestra. Fourth graders, raise your hands. Inspired with this melody, and it's become very famous. Here's New World Symphony. Was originally written for trumpets, but we're going to play it here on strings. So one of the things I'm really going to miss about this fifth grade class, both band and orchestra, is just this class in particular just has an amazing sense of humor, and we joke around a lot, and we have a lot of fun. So they want me to tell you the story that goes with the little thing in your program. So we're about to play a song called Defender of Time, and it says, in loving memory of Mrs. Griffin's watch. So here's the legend of Mrs. Griffin's watch, and it has become legend at Salford Hills. Last year, well, I'm a little bit of a boisterous conductor. I don't know if you noticed that. And I had a watch that was like a bracelet-type watch that didn't complete in class. And we had a song and band called Alpha Squadron. And I was waving furiously, and my watch came off and broke into pieces. And it was, you know, quite earth-shaking for a rehearsal that this happened. And so I pieced my watch back together and got a screwdriver and made it work and function again. And then we got to the next orchestra rehearsal, and we were playing a song called Dragon Hunter, which was also, you know, a very feisty song. And my watch flew off again, this time right in front of the violin's feet, and broke and shattered and worked no more. So my watch died. So, of course, I wrote a little epitaph and put it in my room. It says, rest in peace, Mrs. Griffin's watch. And it says the date that it exploded. And it says, flew in Alpha Squadron, killed by Dragon Hunter. If only I'd had more time. This is fifth grade humor. So, I said, now I have the song for you to play in loving memory of my watch. So we are about to play Defender of Time. It is also a ferocious sounding song, so be prepared. And we have our percussionist Levi and Max joining us to give you some nice clock essences with gongs and tick-tocks and bells going off. So that's going to be happening too. Here's Defender of Time.
Thank you. try and move as quickly as possible?
Yes.
Okay, here we go.
Now it is time for our last group, our fourth and fifth grade chorus. Our first piece is titled Rain Song by Mary Lynn Lightfoot. This piece describes how gentle and playful rain can be. It also has syncopation, which is when the steady beat is on a weak beat instead of a strong beat. You'll hear this towards the end of the piece. Following Rain Song will be Gifts by Mark Winston. This song is based on the Shaker tune Simple Gifts and tells us that giving our talents, our positive thoughts, and love to those around us can make the world a better place. Hey Lily, did you see how cloudy it was today? I think it rained storms rolling in. You're right, be on the lookout for a rainstorm, everyone. Our next piece is called Scales and Arpeggios from the Disney movie The Aristocats. It describes how important it is to practice scales and arpeggios to become a great musician. This piece also has solfège, which are music syllables we use to help us learn a scale. They also have specific hand signs to go along with them. Be sure to watch for them. After that will be Octopus's Garden, originally written by the famous rock band The Beatles. You're welcome to sing along with us if you know the words.
Every truly cultured music student knows you must learn your skills and your arpeggios.
last piece of the night is called Amani Utupe by Pasty Ford Sims. Amani Utupe is Swahili for grant us peace, give us courage, and was originally dedicated to a family in Kenya, Africa. This piece is one of our favorites, and we hope you enjoy it. Thank you for coming to our concert tonight.
Notes of thanks from me. Of course, thank you to all of these lovely humans on the stage. You're doing a fantastic job. Thank you to all the Southern Hill staff, especially Mrs. DePiro, Mrs. Blackie, Dr. Purnell, Mrs. Marichello, who's our accompanist, who takes some extra special time.
Thank you very much and have a safe trip home.